Hi, everyone. Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today, we're going to talk about fractal thinking. What's a fractal? Well, I'm sure you've all heard that word. It's a small part of a whole, and that's really the part of the definition. You know, there's geometry and stuff involved, but for purposes of this discussion, it's going to be part of a larger system, right? So when you're talking about resolution, room resolution, it requires you to think at a micro level, not a macro level. First, you want to start small and work up. You want to look at each wall, floor, ceiling as a part, but also as a whole. And that's how you get to resolution, when you treat the part the same as the whole. Now, what does that mean? Okay, so we have to look at each floor and system as a part. We know there's the three sound fields, right? Floor, ceiling, sidewall, sidewall, front to rear. Each fractal or each of these surface areas has a different frequency and amplitude of issue. So when we view each surface area as a system unto itself, so to speak, even though it's a fractal or part of the whole room, that's how we get resolution. And that's why you're always hearing me say rate and level of absorption are important, because I know what it takes to get resolution in middle frequencies. I figured that out. It took 8 years, but I figured it out. And it's, you know, there's a linearity involved in the absorption curve for music and voice. Music and voice are different. One size does not fit all, okay? So we add up all the fractals, surface area, and what do we get? Well, we get pressure and reflections, because now we got a box, a container. And that's subject to the laws of physics. So each fractal, each wall surface area has different levels that we need to treat. And we want to keep the rate, if we use an absorption, the same. So we want to go to the level that the surface area requires, but then we want to keep the rate uniform on all surface areas. That's why I always harp on rate of absorption. Anybody can build a box to go to 40 hertz. How much per square foot are you getting at 40 hertz? There's the challenge. There's the challenge. And look at our data for that. So the goal for the system, obviously, is pressure and reflection balanced. Now, the only way to get really good pressure balance, oh, we also have the modal pressure, of course. And then we got direct versus reflected energy, room sound. But the CAW is the only way to get the room pressure balance, because you turn the whole wall into a pressure balancing absorber and you absorb every 14 and a half inches. So, you know, if you're framing out on a wood stud, you're going every 14 and a half inches, you're going to put treatment or carbon technology. So we can control the frequency and the amplitude of the problem at that surface area every 14 and a half inches. That's why you get such good control. That's why you get such a beautiful room. That's why we can guarantee frequency response on new builds. So there's part of a whole, part of a whole, fractal part of a whole. You have to start thinking like that. The only way to achieve room resolution, we try to get 80% or higher, is to think like this. You have to look at each part as a whole system, and each part as a part of another system. Fractal thinking. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.